Hello, let's start with our fourth section and start to split our application into pieces. First, some aspects of the user interface. We start with a short overview about different ways to create the UI in a distributed application. Then we move the login from the Bookmarks application to its own service. While the latter is a valid approach, we also want to explore a new way, which is Web Components. So first, we have a look at what Web Components are. Then we create a few of them to display the bookmarks. And at the end, we also add the edit and create form for the bookmarks to the application. Welcome to the subsection about different approaches to do web UIs in a microservice-based application. First, we start with a short overview about popular approaches for the user interface of distributed applications. Then we have a closer look at the shared layout and asset approach using libraries. And as last topic, we check out Web Components as an alternative to the library approach. There are a large number of different flavors for distributed user interfaces out there. I think they more or less can be distilled into one of these seven approaches or mixed versions of them. Let's go quickly through them. Big front-end modules. First and easiest approach is to keep the whole user interface in one or only a few services. A common pattern is a front-end application for the customer-facing side and an administration UI, and both talk to the corresponding services to perform their tasks or compile data to show a web page. You have the layout of the whole page and the UI that represents the important business parts of your services in the front-end service. It's obviously easy to have a consistent user interface because everything is in one place and you don't need to copy-paste between services. Basically, this is very handy when you start to cut a big application into pieces. But you have everything under one roof, so you might end up with conflicting interests, for example, regarding library versions, etc. Over time, you will end up with a big ball of mud that is hard to maintain. When the business demands grow and it gets more complicated, also, this is in general very bad when you have multiple teams working on the application, because merge conflicts and conflicting timetables are very, very likely. Copy-paste between modules. You could just copy and paste so every service gets its own user interface, and then you just use a reverse proxy in front to map URLs to these services. By the way, in my example, I have two proxy services. Of course, you can also have just one. It doesn't really matter. Just copy and paste the layout and maybe even assets everywhere. This is very easy with only a handful of services. Gets quickly out of hand, so please don't do that. Although this approach enables the services to have their own user interface, which is in that regard better than approach one, but it gets quickly out of hand to synchronize everything. So I wouldn't suggest to do that for a real-world project. It may be tempting to use iframes, where the layout is, for example, served by the proxy server and the content of the iframes is provided by the services through the reverse proxy. But iframes is another approach that I wouldn't recommend. It seems easy and you have a decentralized user interface, but you are very limited in your UI creation. The iframe communication with the whole page is limited and your elements can't cover more than the iframe. So for example, no dialogues that are larger than the frame, no dark shadow that covers the whole page as a background shadow, etc. Also, to allow iframes, for example, to switch to a completely different page is, to say the least, not preferable in terms of security. My suggestion is to not do this approach. Handwritten JavaScript and JavaScript libraries. You can have the base layout and management JavaScript code that is served, for example, by the reverse proxy, which in turn loads HTML fragments from the services if necessary. This can be achieved with custom JavaScript or libraries like Unpoly. I prefer, if you do this, use a well-tested library. If you use this approach, you will see that it's relatively simple and you can have a separated UI segments everywhere, which is not bad, but the HTML fragments are sometimes limited, and a lot of glue code and application logic may still end up on the proxy or whatever serves your base templates. This is something that is worth considering. Library and shared assets. This is one approach that we will have a closer look at. You create, for example, a jar file that just contains some FileMyLeaf templates with a Java code, if necessary, and a few assets. This library will be used by all services, and every service just renders the full page. This is possible because you can load FileMeLeaf templates from everywhere in the class path without additional code. There is also a variant where you create a template loader that fetches the templates and assets from the database. This is also possible with moderate effort on your part. The library variant is easier to implement, but has danger that services use a different version of the layout, which may lead to an inconsistent user experience. Or you load the templates, for example, from a database, which requires more code and may be a bit slower than local file access. This is how it would look like when the service fetches the data from the database. The service fetched the templates using a custom template resolver from the database and renders the content. This is nice because you have immediate synchronization for all services, but requires local caching and a very detailed migration strategy when you update the layouts, because every change needs to be compatible with all services that use the template and run at the same time. The approach is pretty promising. You have a dedicated user interface and it's pretty easy to implement. Every service can pick and choose, and it can even use the shared Java code for shared functionality to load, for example, data about the current user or how the server fetches data from the main menu or whatever. My main problem with this approach is that it will become harder over time to evolve the layout library because all services will depend on it. And a small change may lead to a big problem during the deployment of all services somewhere with a lot of work to migrate all of them. For small and medium-sized applications, this could work pretty good. When the application grows larger, the interdependency of all services through this library will become a problem sooner or later. Also, you will have a problem if you use different technologies for your services. Web components are relatively new and allow you to write new HTML components or complete single-page applications using a few standard mechanisms that we will explore further in later videos of this section. We will also use a small portion of what is possible here, but the main enabling factor is that we can load elements when we need them from our services. You can even use components of a service in the UI of another service, which enables you to have a very consistent UI. I'm not a big front-end and JavaScript developer myself, and when I can work with it, I'm sure you can do as well. The layout will need to know which services are there and wire up some high-level web components from them, which enables us to create rich applications with a relatively high degree of separation between the services. But you will see that later in action, which will make things a lot clearer. If you use this approach, you will also have a lot of freedom, separated UI segments, and you can rely on a growing library of very nice components that you can simply use. This makes it really easy, even for me, to create rich user interfaces that offer a high usability, and you have maintainable code. The main drawbacks are, in my point of view, that this requires at least some JavaScript or TypeScript, and when you have to target very old browsers, even the Podophyll library that emulates some features for older browsers may fail you somewhere. But overall, this is my favorite approach so far. As I said, user interfaces are not my strong field of expertise, so take this section with a grain of salt, as it represents the approach to do a user interface from a backend guy's perspective. A pure front-end developer will have a different opinion for sure. There is no one-size-fits-all approach. You have to decide for yourself what fits in your current situation. We will try at least two approaches in this section.